very important that we know as much as we can about the nominees, candidates who are running for sheriff and coroner. We appreciate you taking the time. But we'll start immediately to my left, and we'll let Mr. Ron McDonald make his opening statements.
Thank you, Ethan. Thank you, Republican Party. Thank you all for being here. I see a lot of familiar faces from all the other debates, but I still appreciate y'all taking the time away from your families. First day of summer, great day, great hot day, great day to campaign. I am Warren McDonald, and I want to be your next sheriff. I moved to this community 15 years ago. I chose to move here. I chose to build my business here and chose to raise my family here. During that time, my investment that I've made is paralleling everything that I want to do today. I want to invest back in this community with my service. As your coroner of 11 and a half years, I've worked parallel with the sheriff's office. I've investigated all the many deaths throughout this community, some real tough situations from the antifreeze case to the assisted suicide cases. And that was done inside the city of Cumming. And that was done through our coroner's office working with the Georgia Bureau of Investigations. That has made me shown that my leadership through the coroner's office, my leadership and my business makes me the best candidate for the sheriff's office. Some of the things that we need to do is, as sheriff, we need to get back and get in the lives of our children. We've got to get in our schools. We've got to let these kids know the repercussions, the decisions that they're making today will be with them. They will be with them the rest of their life. We've got to let them understand, get the foundation built back for them so that they know right from wrong. And it starts a lot with the sheriff's office in our school system. I want to thank my wife and my daughter, Haley. They're here with me tonight. Fortunately, my two boys, they're at camp for 2 weeks. I never thought I'd miss my two boys, but I do, and I'm ready to pick them up this Saturday. So we're going to have a day away from the campaign and have a family weekend in Chattanooga picking up my kids at my old high school. But again, I want to thank the party. Thank you all for taking the time to come out tonight.
Thank you, Ethan, and I too would like to thank the Republican Party for putting on this forum tonight and giving us the opportunity to have all of you here. Once again, thank each and every one of you for being here and taking the time to participate. My name is Ted Paxton. I have had the honor to serve this community as your sheriff since 2001. During that time, as all of you are well aware, our county has seen a tremendous amount of growth. We have been transformed from a small rural county in the northern foothills of Georgia to now a very vibrant part of the urban Atlanta area. And with that, we've grown the sheriff's office, managed the sheriff's office to meet the needs of all the new growth that came into the county. During that time, in 2003, I led the agency through being accredited by the Commission on Accreditation of Law Enforcement Agencies. It's a voluntary program which we participate in to demonstrate to the members of this community that we are dedicated to the highest levels of professionalism in law enforcement to serve the people in this community. Over the years, we've been very, very fortunate where we have received a tremendous number of awards, recognitions from national law enforcement associations as to the work we do here locally in Forsyth County. As we look to the future, biggest endeavor we have facing us right now as far as the sheriff's office is concerned is the construction of a new jail. As you're well aware, back last November, voters of the county approved a local option sales tax to pay for the construction of a new jail and a new courthouse. Those projects are underway, and it's my commitment that the jail portion of that project comes in on time, as can be done, and well within its budget. Thank you very much once again. It's been an honor to serve you as your sheriff, and I look forward to continuing to serve in that capacity. Thank you.
Last but not least, Mr. Duane.
I want to thank the Republican Party for hosting the event, but most of all, thank you all for taking the time to be here. My name is Duane Piper, and I'm running for sheriff of Forsyth County. My wife and I moved here about 19 years ago. We raised our two children here. Our daughter-in-law is from this area, which means that my granddaughters are going to be growing up in Forsyth County. I have a vested interest in our community. After 4 years in the military, the 82nd Airborne Division, I've spent 25 years in law enforcement. A very broad range of experience in law enforcement. I've been had the advantage of having worked under a wide variety of leaders with different leadership styles. Tonight I'll be presenting you some information, some facts. The source of the information is open records requests and the county's website. During three terms of the incumbents, the sheriff's been incumbent for the past three terms, the budget started out at about $12.5 million. At this point, the budget is $37.5 million. That is a 199% increase. We've tripled our sheriff's office budget at the same time that the county's population only grew by 78%. I mention this because that's a very disturbing trend when you consider the Forsyth County Sheriff's Office consumes 41% of the county's overall operational budget. This has got to be gotten up. We have to get this under control. As your sheriff, I will bring fiscal responsibility to the Forsyth County Sheriff's Office. I'll return the focus on serving the community so that we can maintain the community we all chose to live in. Thank you.
Well, thank you, gentlemen. We're now moving into our final phase of the debate. We will start with, I think we'll start on this end of the stage, here, whatever this is called. We'll start with Mr. Piper, if you could give a minute and a half closing statement.
I'm basically going to give you a recap of my opening statement. 25 years of law enforcement. I know what you mean. 25 years of law enforcement. Broad range of experience. What it comes down to is leadership and budgets. Our budget, once again, has tripled at the same time the population has only gone up by 78%. There is no logical explanation for that other than we're not doing some of the things we talked about here today. We're not looking at what we don't need anymore. We're not looking at what we're doing and constantly getting better. We're going to have to make a change. The change needs to be made. It needs to be made before we still got a handle on this. I listened to some of the commissioners' debates yesterday, and I was shocked. I did not know how deeply in debt our county is. The hundreds of millions of dollars, if I'm not mistaken, of debt that's coming on to us. The sheriff's office controls 41% of the county's overall operating budget. That's a tax driver. I'll do my part to get us out of that debt.
Thank you. Once again, I'd just like to thank all of each and every one of you for being here. Once again, just to recap, I have had the honor and distinct pleasure to serve this community as your sheriff since 2001. I look forward to continuing to serve in that capacity. You know, we talk about a lot of things. We talk about budgets. We talk about comparing to this entity, that entity. People want to do that, just go check it out for yourself. It's very hard to compare two or any more of them on their surface because every county does their budgeting and their figures in a different way. So please seek out what is actually true. Once again, I'm standing on my record of what we've done, what we've accomplished, where we've come to. We have a community that is very safe, you're correct. But I will counter that the reason it is very safe is because of the work that we have done, the way we've trained the deputies, how they've applied that out in the field, the many programs we have in place. That's why we are where we are today. It's been my pleasure to serve you as your sheriff, and I look forward to continuing to serve in that capacity. Thank you so much.
Mr. McDonald.
Again, I want to thank Mr. Underwood, the party. Thank you all for coming out tonight. I want to thank this community for its support of my family over the years personally, the support y'all have given me as your coroner over the past 11 and a half years. As your next sheriff, I want to give you my values, my ethics, my leadership, my trust, my character. It's demanded at my home. I want to offer that to you. It's needed in this community. Got a lot of challenges coming up. And as your next sheriff, I will meet those challenges, and I won't let you down, I promise you. Again, thank you for being here tonight.
Gentlemen, thank you very much. We appreciate you being here. Folks, just give them a round of applause. everyone will stay for one. A little known fact that some of people may not be aware of, that in the event of a vacation at the sheriff's office, the coroner can be called to serve in his stead. So coroner is a very important office. I hope that you will stay and participate in our debates. They'll be starting at 7:45. We'll take a brief break until then. Thank you.
What have you done?
Isn't that what Ted Paxton said?
What?
When he was drunk on the ground? What have you done?
I'm good, how are you?
What have you done?
What have you done?
That guy who was mad at you for, I have no idea why.
He was mad. He was going to blow off on somebody, and I guess you became his target.
He was looking for somebody.
And you know, when you're my size, people do that to me too.